Is this something that the beast of the green hell is scared of?
You can see that this is activated.
Hello.
Oh my lord, this car is so fast. Holy moly.
I guess you guys will agree with me, right? What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we've got an awesome car. I can say that. I guess you guys will agree with me, right? This is one of the angriest and meanest looking cars out there today. It is awesome. So today we're going to check it out, see what the differences are between this and a regular AMG GTR, because today we've got the GTR Pro. Basically the track focused, most insane version of the AMG GT lineup. And well, I'm going to show you all around it, show you all the cool aero on it. Then we will take it for a drive on this beautiful road towards the Autobahn and take it for a quick Autobahn blast over there. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to receive updates when we upload a new video, so you don't miss any of these cool videos with these awesome cars. And you can also check out our new watch. It's called the Matterhorn. It's limited to 30 pieces, Swiss made watch, with a green nylon strap and some cool red details. So if you like it, you can go and check it out in the top right corner in our store. Now, let's take a look at this car. Let's take a proper look at this car, shall we? Because it looks so mean. And there are a couple of reasons for that. Reason number one, check out those headlights. This is a facelift, so these headlights are much more aggressive, much more like on the AMG GT four-door. They squint a little bit more, they're a little bit more sharp, and these LEDs are also a little bit more angry. So believe me, when you have this car in your rear view mirror, it looks terrifying, basically. It's awesome. Okay, so let's take a look at this very cool front splitter with these aluminium brackets to hold them in place. Very beautiful carbon fiber with some more. Oh, that's actually just body. Check out how intricate this is. This is just body flowing between the splitter and the lower part of the splitter. So you can see that this is an extra little thing of carbon fiber that comes out of there, goes here to the left, and then flows into this freaking awesome winglet. We've got another winglet right there. Hello. Someone call Snow White and see if she lost anyone. Okay, so cool. We've got some aero right there as well, that air flows through here. We've got some radiators, more there and there. We've got some vents right here that let out the air that gets trapped in the wheel wells. So air is released from here, which means that lift is reduced and you get more downforce. You also get on the Pro these super awesome forged lightweight wheels with carbon ceramic brakes, also as standard on the Pro. But weirdly, you don't get the bronze golden colored calipers you usually get with AMG carbon ceramic brakes. Don't know why that is. So just like the regular GTR, it has Michelin Pilot Sport Cup 2 tires, 19 at the front, 20 at the rear, 325 at the rear actually, so that's a massive tire. And the cool thing is about this car that even though it has just as much horsepower as the regular GTR, 585 horsepower, 700 newton meters, it has the same Michelin Pilot Sport Cup 2 tires, and still this car is 7 seconds faster on the Nürburgring. And that's all down to aero and the suspension tweaks, which I will tell you a little bit more about later. But since the regular GTR is called Beast of the Green Hell, what's this? Is this something that the Beast of the Green Hell is scared of? Or is there something like that? Is this the Yeti of the Green Hell? Okay, moving on. We've got more carbon fiber blades on the side, which are gorgeous V8 bi-turbo badge, carbon fiber side skirts, carbon fiber mirror caps, carbon fiber roof. There are those 325 section tires at the rear, massive and stacked tire or wheel sizes, so 20 and 19. I always think that looks so cool because you can really see it, and the car is raked a little bit because of that. So moving on, more carbon fiber blades right there that go into the diffuser, which is also very intricate. A lot of stuff going on here, a little bit of heat shielding. It's a double diffuser, so air flows through it and underneath it. Exhaust pipes, some more aero right there. And of course the big wing you also get on a GTR, but the GTR Pro gets this little gurney flap as well to give it even more downforce. So take a look at the engine. There we have the 4-liter V8 bi-turbo. As I said, it's just as powerful as a regular GTR. So nothing has happened here really. We've got the carbon fiber, optional carbon fiber cover on the engine. Well, not really on the engine because the engine is right there behind the front wheels, as you can see. So this is not where this car has been changed compared to the regular GTR. The biggest change, of course, next to that insane aero, is the suspension. They changed the suspension completely. It has completely different coilovers, which are manually adjustable. It also has manually adjustable anti-roll bars, which are carbon fiber at the front, saving 3.3 kilos. But the suspension is also manually adjustable, and I can show you guys. Because you can check it out right here. Gives us some time to check out this awesome AMG badge right there. The roll cage, so this is part of the track package. You can also get that on a regular GTR, which gives you the roll cage, the 4-point harness and the fire extinguisher. So this car is 40 kilos lighter than a regular GTR because of all that carbon fiber. Those bucket seats also save some weight because they are also carbon fiber. But because you have the roll cage and the fire extinguisher and stuff, it adds 15 kilos. So this car in total is 25 kilos lighter than a GTR. And this is what I wanted to show you guys. This is the little knob you can use to change the suspension. So this is for the rebound. You can actually change the bump, rebound and ride height of this suspension. I'm not going to turn it because I think AMG has set it up for us already. But this is so cool. Those little knobs, it's just so cool. Of course, we've got the GTR Pro badge with the little finish flag and the green R right there. So you guys can rate the exterior of this car. I'll walk around it once more. You can check out all that sick aero. Oh man, I just love the way this car looks. You can rate it in the top right corner. Go vote. And on the inside, we've got a lot of Alcantara and leather. So basically the entire door is Alcantara with a little bit of leather right there. The dash, the upper part is leather, the lower part is Alcantara. We've got an AMG badge stamped on there, more Alcantara. Alcantara seats as well with leather. These are actually super nice. You can see the carbon fiber right there. Beautiful. With the optional gray seat belt as well, which I think looks really cool. Alcantara steering wheel with a nice gray 12 o'clock marker and AMG logo, and of course the new configurable buttons we know and love from AMG nowadays. It also has the very intricate traction control system from the GTR. So with this button, if you turn it off completely, the traction control, you can then adjust it with this button going from off to on. And that's the cool thing about this GTR Pro. It is really built for the track. It's meant for, well, let's be honest, rich people to take their GTR Pro, drive it on the road towards the track where they can really use it. And you can use this traction control system according to the circumstances. So if it's a little bit damp, you get a little bit more traction control. If it's dry and hot, you get a little bit less. Then you can take it out for a lap, change this, maybe change something on the suspension while you're in the pits, and go out again and see if you can, you know, improve your time or if it feels better with your adjusted suspension. I think that's really cool, and I hope that a lot of these people, of the 750 of these pros that will be built, the owners will really take it out and drive it on track like it's meant to be, and not just, you know, stick it in a climate controlled garage. Okay, so with that, we're going to drive it, of course. Okay, so let's take it for a drive. I'm super happy that they included a regular seatbelt as well, because those four-point harnesses are awesome, but not that nice for everyday use. As I said, we've got the new configurable stuff, so we can use this button for the driving modes. We'll just put it in race, and then we can use these to configure all kinds of stuff: nose lift, traction control, exhaust. Really, really cool. It's so nice that you have this, you know, just at your fingertips. We'll also put the gearbox in manual, and if we turn off traction control, you can see that this is activated, and you can adjust it with this button going from on to off in 9 different settings. Really, really cool. So for now, we're just going to put it in ESP sport mode. Okay, let's take it for a drive towards the Autobahn. I'll get the speedo cam going for the rev counter, so you guys can watch that as well. Just get rid of some of these little stones. And this car has four-wheel steering, which you can actually feel really well if you do like this, because you can actually feel the car moving around really weirdly. Okay, so the GTR Pro, being the most track-focused weapon in the GT lineup, it also has unibolt steel bearings on the upper part of the wishbones. The regular GTR only has that on the lower part. So that means that you have even more connection with the chassis, because there's less rubber. Okay, we're in ESP sport mode right now. We're in manual. I'll put that in drive. So now we can do a launch control. Just foot on the brake, full throttle. Oh, little bit of traction issues there. So let's see what happens if we just turn on the traction control. Zero to 100, 3.6 seconds, same as the GTR. Top speed 318 or 317 kilometers an hour. But you can really feel it hooking up once, you know, once it can get that power down, because it's, you know, it's a bit of a cold day. There's a lot of moist in the air, so those tires, they need a lot of heat in them to start working properly. So I can only compare this GTR to my personal experience in an AMG GTS or GTC. I can't compare it to a GTR since I haven't driven it, but a couple of journalists did tell me that the GTR is really hard and stiff, and that because of that, the car sometimes gets a little bit unsettled when you hit some bumps. And just the sheer quality of this suspension setup and the fact they can manually adjust it means that even though this car feels really hard and taut, it's still very compliant. And it also means that the car doesn't get unsettled when you hit a couple of bumps, that it still keeps, you know, keeps going straight, and it doesn't surprise you with any weird movements. Oh, listen to those downshifts. I will say this though, this car sounds, of course the car sounds really good, especially going through the gears, that 7-speed dual clutch gearbox. But they all sort of sound the same, which I think is a shame. I would have loved if this GTR Pro would have sounded even crazier. So still struggling for traction there. But the thing that I notice most about this car is just
the directness and the agility. You turn this car in and it just goes. The steering is pretty light, it's pretty direct. As you can see, there are some bumps here, but the car copes really well. Oh, those carbon ceramic brakes slowing you down. This car is insane. Oh my lord, this car is so good. Sometimes, you know, you can be impressed or taken away by a car because of its sound, because of its looks. But it doesn't happen that often that I'm so blown away by the way a car feels in my hands. You know, it feels like I can yield this weapon and I can actually steer it and coax it around with my mind. It's so insane how good and well balanced this car feels. It's insane. It's insane. It's just mind-blowing. I'm telling you guys, it's one of the best cars I've ever driven to drive on a bit of road like that. Oh, man. Love it when that happens. Hey, look at that. That's our friend again. So we are here at the Autobahn and we are going in the direction of Heilbronn to see what this is like on the Autobahn, because I have not driven it on the Autobahn yet. Oh, that's a sick downshift. Oh, little slide. Michelins are still not really up to temperature. I told you before, you really need to get those hot for maximum grip. Oh, this thing is fast! Holy moly! Oh, that's 250. Oh man! Dear Lord! It just feels so urgent and aggressive and ramming through those gears. That engine is so brutal, such a brute, it's relentless. AMG took a lot of this hardware, a lot of this know-how from their very successful AMG GT, GT3 and GT4 race cars. And you can actually feel that this car has, you know, some of that hardware and the setup, because it feels more like a race car than it does a supercar, because it is so, it's just so direct and unfiltered that it really makes me want to drive it on a track like on the Nürburgring or on the Bilsenberg track or on Spa or whatever. It just makes me long for a track with this car. Oh, that's 282. Oh, this thing flies. It's actually the fastest stock car we've tested from 100 to 200 kilometers an hour, 6.4 seconds. It's just mental. And I feel so connected to what's happening underneath me that I feel very confident of doing this corner in 250 kilometers an hour plus. you know what's happening underneath you. And if they do that, then you're having a great day, because it's just so rewarding to drive a car like this. It's honestly one of the best cars I've driven. It's right up there. What an absolute monster of a car. Oh, I'm drooling in here. I'm sorry, guys. It's just, apart from that sound, which I think, you know, is the same as in a GTS or a GTC, I just have very little to complain about in this car. It is magnificent. So thanks to AMG for inviting us out to Avaltabak to come and drive this car. It was a pleasure. Thanks to you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. You can subscribe by clicking the big button in the middle. You can check out this video, or you can go and check out this playlist. See you at the next one, guys. Bye.